Good evening. Bonus, Sarah. It is, what is it, 8:05 p.m. And I'm finally back for playing video games that aren't Pokemon, at least. How are y'all doing tonight? I am, today, firing up my Nintendo Wii for the first time in a long time, and I am going to return to the ocean, as is my tradition in October. Two Octobers hence, we did EverBlue for the PlayStation, and now we're back at it with the sequel, Endless Ocean, which I'm sure will be just as terrifying. I was very, very frightened of the sharks in the previous game, and I'm expecting that will be the case, or continue to be the case in this one. Here's hoping, at the very least. But yeah, that's pretty much the plan. Mondays this month, I'm going to try and get through this game. I don't know how long it's time to beat score is, but we'll find out together, I suppose. What did I want to do? Oh yeah, I also made like a funny little trailer for all of this. Let me actually show that. One second. Where did I put it? Where do I store all my crap these days? Projects, miscellaneous. This one. Yeah, so, question from the chat, is there a Tommy on this Wii? I think the answer is yes. But yeah, I'm very excited about this. I loved EverBlue. The game scared the crap out of me as a child, but then after replaying it more recently, I think it's probably one of my top 10 games of its era. It's definitely criminally underrated. Let's see if there's a Tommy. I'm literally going to open my Mii channel on stream here. We're going to see what happens. What did I think I looked like last time I booted this up? Excellent question. There's quite a lot of Miis. Quite a lot of them. I don't think any of these are me, though. I see what looks to be Jesus Christ. We got Eggman over here. That's definitely Eggman. Yep. Is this Diddy Kong? Oh, Yellow Monkey from, Ape Escape. None of these look like me, though. Or like any incarnation of me. This one's pretty cool, though. But I didn't make this one. Every Wii has a robotic me, yeah? They all got like... We got Alien Hominid from Alien Hominid. This one's a frog. Pretty good. Okay, none of these look like me. That's okay. Nobody uses this anyway. The game we're gonna play is not gonna feature Miis anyway. Not. Oh, here's Hello Kitty. Also, that's cool. And I believe this must be Peter Griffin. There we go. Petet. Excellent. Great stuff. How do we get out of here? Just back to the Wii menu. There we go. Neither here nor there. We're not dealing with Miis today. But yeah, EverBlue. If you haven't seen it, I have my full Let's Play up on my YouTube archive. One of my favorite games. It's a game about diving and salvaging. The overworld is like a point and click, and then the ocean aspect is like very fully rendered 3D. Very cool. They definitely set out to do what they wanted to do. But now we're going to play this one, which I'm very excited about. The sequel, therefore the third game in the installments of EverBlue. Actually, hold on. One more thing. Let me put this on my co-host before I go live. I should let people know that I'm doing that. That's important. If I'm ever going to pretend like I'm using co-host as a supplementary social media site, I gotta actually walk the walk. He will recoast, thank you. What am I looking for? Thank you, though. I appreciate it. I hope you're all doing well this evening. I'm not sure if the Monday time slot's good, but I really don't have any other time in my entire life or week or anything that I could possibly dedicate to this. It is now or never, because Tuesdays are for Pokemon. I run Pokemon Locals on Thursday, IRL, so I couldn't possibly do it then. Twitch.tv/Skeletom. CH. Tags, we're gonna be Skeletom. VTuber. Endless Ocean. Everybody's in that Endless Ocean tag, I'm sure of it. And I gotta attach my thumbnail, which I definitely have. There we go. Alright, it's been coasted. We're coasting out here. Choastin. Okay, with all that done, all the administrative paperwork out of the way, I think I can actually play the video game I assembled everybody here to play tonight. Endless Ocean, made by Arika, who you might know from Tetris the Grandmaster, or Street Fighter EX. They also made not one, not two, not three, but four diving RPGs for some reason. All of them were commercial failures, as far as I'm aware, but they kept making them, and I couldn't really tell you why. I'm very excited about them. Happy to experience it. This one's going to be fun, too, because I only need the Wii Remote to play this one, not even the Nunchuck. So I can do this one-handed while I, like, flail my left hand and point at stuff on the stream. You might actually see my right hand come into frame sometime, because I am waving it about. Also, the stream is about to get DMCA'd now. This part will be muted in the VOD, guaranteed.
Let your arms enfold us through the dark of night. Will your angels hold us till we see. Thank you.
when I booted this console up and popped this in the disc tray and heard the OP again for the first time in what must have been close to 14 years, I felt the most powerful, like, immobilizing wave of nostalgia I can imagine. It was so strong. I forgot that this game arbitrarily has a 4.5 minute piece of licensed music as, like, its opening for no discernible reason. That is Prayer by Haley Westerna, and it is definitely licensed, and I'm definitely getting the VOD muted for playing it, but gosh darn it, y'all needed to hear it. It's important to the game experience. Alright, so let's do a new game. Well, good day there. Welcome to Mana Ally, the pride and joy of the Pelago Commonwealth. Now, Customs needs your information, so let's get started with a name and gender. Alright, name is going to be... doing this, of course, with the Wii remote. Yes. My favorite way to type is by using a pointer. And this isn't QWERTY, of course. Let's go, Skeletom Nation! It's on the TV, thank you. Music is really loud. Okay, thank you. That's good to know. So, I can fix this. I have the power. Game Grumps played this, interesting. Yeah, this game's old. It came out in, I think, 2007. 9, actually. Okay. Hold on. Hey, Tom. Welcome. That must be way better, right? That's gotta be better. If it's not, I can adjust it further. Sorry about that. No games are equalized the same, so it's always a crapshoot every time you play a new game. I'm using the same sound settings for when I stream off of my 3DS, which is much quieter comparatively. Okay, Skeletom Nation. Is this okay? Yes. Are you a boy or a girl? I do have it such that the game volume goes down when I speak. Yes, I have ducking in place. Is that obnoxious or not? I think that's good. People have told me it's good, but if you don't like it, I can turn it off. I'll tailor every stream to the whims of the few. It's fine. The vocal minority will get their way. Boy. Oh yeah, it looks just like me. Perfect likeness. Splendid name, that is. He's so right. It's such a good name. But I'm not sure we got your picture right, so let me ask you a few more questions. What kind of tan are you hoping for? No. None. White as could be. It's a bit aggressive. But it's shutting down too quickly? Is you're saying the ducking is too aggressive? Turn it off. It might not have a place in a game like this. I have it set originally, actually, from when I was doing coverage of Worlds. I was like, oh, ducking makes sense here. I'll just turn ducking off. That's fine. We don't need it. There we go. I think you're probably right. I had it from when I had to talk over, like, other casters and other speakers, but I don't think I need it. I think you're probably correct. Hairstyle. What are my options? Mild or wild? Yeah! Wild. Pulled back, absolutely. Such a deep character customization. Oh man, what my depth of color options for hair, black or brown? It's brown. Wow, golly, this is a deep character creator. The hairstyle binary, yeah, they gotta do this on Monster Factory. L square. Yeah, that's me. That looks exactly like me. My immigration procedure. Greatest diving location. Take your time and explore to your heart's content. I know you're going to love Manoalai. Have a great time. So, last time I played this game, I had this guy with silver hair, so I must have unlocked that. I also apparently played this game for like 13 hours, which is crazy. Game is still loud. I don't know if I believe you. I think you're lying to me. Well, I can fix that. I can continue over it. See, you missed the ducking now. Everybody's complaining about this, that, and the other thing. That's gotta be good. I hope that's what you're looking for. If not, too bad. Alright. Perfect. Good to know. So I wonder how I got the silver hair on the previous guy. Must have been a thing you can buy later. Press any button to continue. Do I get more licensed music? I'm hoping so. That's a familiar noise. Tom. Yes. That's me. That's the guy I am. Yeah, Denji. Did you ever play Echo the Dolphin? I didn't have a Genesis, if you can believe it or not, so no. I have played it, like, more recently, but I've never beaten it. I don't believe it's very good. But I could do that game one of these days, but if I ever run out of seafaring games. Oh, can you hear me? I'm your partner. My name's Catherine Sunday. I should be playing this game on Sunday, then. Oh, man, that'd be funny. I could do Catherine Sundays, where I play with Catherine Sunday. I'm told the first Echo of the Dolphin's pretty good, but like the other one, the following ones are just very difficult. The controls seem very obtuse, which is kind of par for the course with Sega. You can call me Cat. I'm here to give you advice and help, and whatever else you need. Manoalai is an awesome place, and there's tons to learn. But first, we've got to get you set up to speed. So let's go. First things first, take care of the basics. I'm going to run through the directional control. Well, I've got a Wii remote, so I'm going to guess I point where I want to go. Alright. Point the Wii remote at the screen to change directions accordingly. Try aiming north. Okay. Oh, this'll be fun. Hold on. The Wii also doesn't like that I'm sitting so close to my monitor. Okay, there we go. Looking good. Now try turning east. Okay. Yeah. Do you turn around a lot? Because you're a pro. I guess it turning around. That's some powerful dialogue. Alright, now I can learn how to walk. Cool. To the east. Press the B button. Can do. Hey, let me remind you where B is. Ah, the only other button on this controller. Got it. Yeah. Okay. So this game is third person instead of first person, which I think is... like a downgrade? I liked the first person in EverBlue. Anyway, Denshi, what did you bring? Why do you bring up Echo? Fond memories of it, or just because it's another game that takes place underwater? I am a big Sega fan, typically speaking, so it's not unheard of. No reason, that's fair. Okay, this is the lagoon. It's a small saltwater lake located on the west side of Manoalai Island. It's a good little place for viewing tropical fish. So head east until you reach the center area. Okay. So you really just point and hold the go button. So far. Music's nice. There's an auto swim button. I can just get this game to play itself. Only the most skilled divers can even attempt. Alright, I pressed the other button. Alright, I'm swimming automatically. This ocean can be so many fish, an endless number of fish. Howdy, Cadenza. Welcome. I'm a dive pro. I mean, when I beat EverBlue, it told me I was a diving god, and I got 9999 hit points. So, maybe I am a diving pro. It's unclear. Getting around without any hassle, or for being lazy. Okay, cool. Let's go to the Gabbiano. Alright, return to boat. Tool menu. Huh? Oh. Return to boat. Yes. This game is immediately losing points for being a Wii game, though. Like, I just want a controller. Did you know Gabbiano means seagull in Italian? Yes, I did know that. In fact, you might be dealing with the only streamer of this game who did know that information. Yeah, I don't like the waggle controls, but it's the Wii game, so it's got to be that way. Alright, we knocked off a tiny piece of the map.
Well, you know I'm Italian.
Exactly, Denji. I'm always saying this. Back already? Do you have fun down there? So, EverBlue... Who does she remind me of? She's got, like, a face that reminds me of, like, another video game character, I feel like. Like, big pouty energy. Maybe it's just the glasses. It's not Bayonetta, but the glasses really do have Bayo vibes, I feel like. You watched a whole ton of cave diving accident videos this week. Why, to prepare you for this stream? She could be in Final Fantasy, you're so right. She does look like a Final Fantasy X character. You've just gotten off an awful game of Dota, so the music is soothing me. Well, what hero did you play? Cadenza, I'm very curious. There are so many ways to make a Dota game go bad. It's kind of lonely out here, so it's nice to have company. My job is basically to protect the ocean and all of its creatures. A good job to have. And it's where you come in. I can't do my job without a top diver. I have a ponytail! Oh, that's so excellent, actually. I thought when they told me it was going to be mild or wild, mild was just fully slicked back. But it's just, it's business in the front, but party in the back. What do you do? That's the easy part. That's not mild at all. I look like Venom Snake. Mostly just hang out and dive when you feel like it. Wow, what a good job. Look at this dude, yeah. Spectre Carrion, my support decided to go Exort Invoker. Well, your support being an Invoker is already a rough go of it, I feel like. We have Sun Strikes and other lanes and not really helping yet. If they're going to be a support Invoker, you have to go Quas. You got to get that Cold Snap. You got to get the Urn of Shadows. There's no other way to do it. It's just not going to work out otherwise. You can't go Exort. Okay. We get specific requests from the Marinara's Marianas, sorry, not Marinara. The Marinara Trench, where they get all the sauce from. The Marianas Foundation, sometimes. They provide our funding, so you should probably oblige them, but you don't have to. I mean, who's stopping you? Pretty laid back, huh? I think I'd go crazy if I ever had to work in an office. Do I have a cell phone? If this is a real good Wii game, I get a cell phone and I have to hold it up to my ear. Like, to listen out of the terrible tinny speaker. Oh, but it's just email? Okay. Well, I'm going to the cabin and check the email. Point at a location, hold B to walk in that direction. Wow. Also, Isby, hello, I didn't say hi to you this evening. Thank you for stopping by. Thanks again for recommendation on, Oh, yeah. So that came by way of chat member, Gate. Or I guess he's speaking through DOSMeow right now. That guy's channel was handed to me by them. And I've watched a couple of the videos, and I thought they were pretty good. So I'm happy to recommend them to you. Feel free to discuss in the chat. I'm sure there won't be a whole lot of other noteworthy things going on as I, like, very limply wander around on this boat. This is a very stiff walking animation. This guy's barely using his arms at all. Okay, what can I interact with up here, topside? This? No. This is also a very stark departure. It's true, it's not a great noise. Stark departure from EverBlue, which just had a 2D overworld. It was purely characters doing pre-rendered animations on, like, a very short loop. And it was just a point-click, like, overworld. There was no 3D anything. What's over here? Message board. Hey, it's Catherine. I like to post hints here from time to time. Make sure you check it out. Thanks, Catherine. Catherine's hints on July 1st. I don't think that's not the day that today is, but whatever. To pet things, hold down A and shake the Wii remote. To touch things, just point and press A. I'm always saying this. This is how I interact with my cat. While underwater, press minus once to activate auto swim. Press any button to deactivate auto swim. If you hear the tone from the Wii remote, oh, that's something that you guys will be missing out on, is I'll have to hear the tinny speakers, but it's not going to come through the microphone. Can you pet the fish in this game? Yes, I think that's pretty much the entire gameplay, Denji. I think we're about to find out that petting the fish is really the name of the game here. Press plus to check out any unusual objects nearby. So that's the radar that we primarily focused on in EverBlue, I think. Heck yeah, exactly. If you find an item you want to keep, press A to target it, and then hold down A and press B to grab it. When underwater, you can turn sharply by waving the Wii remote. Alright, let me put the wrist strap on. You can and you must. Yeah, I think that's like the central thrust of gameplay in this one. EverBlue 2 was all about like making money and salvaging stuff, but I think this one's literally just like, what if we made it even lower stress? I'm playing this one during October to follow tradition. I was genuinely afraid of EverBlue when I originally purchased it as a young child, and then when I played it again in 2021, because there's lots of like shark jump scares in that game. I don't know that this game has combat or like a notion of health or anything like that, but October is now just ocean month for me. When underwater, you can turn sharply by waving the river. If you're on the surface of the water, press A to stick your head up. You can look around by moving the cursor. Oh, that's an improvement over the previous game also. As you return to the boat after a dive, I'll show you details about your trip. Okay, you don't have unlimited air in that big tank of yours, so be careful, okay? If you run low, you'll have to pull out, and that's kind of a pain. You can find different animals depending on whether you dive during the day or at night. Ooh. Day is from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. and night is any other time. Night diving is awesome, at least that's what people tell me. Do they mean real time? Am I gonna have to adjust my system clock? No, because it's daytime right now, and it's nighttime where I am. Four distinct seasons in Manoa Live, so some animals only come around during certain ones. If you get bored and want to change scenery, you can change the time from day to night by using the clock. Okay, good. And time passes in real time as well. All marine life has distinct likes and personalities. Guys that live in the dark places are interested in light, while whales and mammals really dig sound. I'm always saying this about sound also. I can't get enough of the stuff. One of the top five senses, for sure. Like, sound, chef's kiss. You'll have to experiment with each animal, see what kind of interaction it really likes. Pressing 2 while on the map will let you zoom in or out. I designed that myself. Do you like it? The yellow mark on the left of the compass shows where you're facing up or down. It's helpful for diving in really dark areas. Well, that's promising. I don't know much about cameras, but you can fiddle with the focus and aperture or whatever it's called by using 2. That was me yesterday. I took a bunch of photos at the zoo and I was just messing with every dial. And I got some good ones. I put them on Twitter. But I am still a novice. Oh boy, hitting these buttons is really difficult. Want to organize your album, point to a photo and pick it up by pressing A and B, and drop it wherever you want. Okay, I'm learning every control of this game up front. Thank you, Catherine. At some point, you'll be able to access the mainland aquarium. You can use one to drop critters in the tank and watch them swim. Cool. If you ever find a really big critter, you can grab it and swim along. Don't worry, they don't mind. Press 2 to change your view. The more you train your partner, the better it will be at tricks. Even a shy little dolphin can become a star, kind of like me. Your partner has to be happy if you want to set records. Make sure to keep training and give it lots of praise. I'm learning about mechanics that will definitely not be introduced in this play session. This is incredible. The strength of your ghost sign affects your partner's tricks, especially one that they get used to, so keep practicing. You can use your camera while you're training. Try taking pictures of your partner sometime. When your partner's performing, press 2 to change the view. Like a movie. Oh my god. You can train your partner to a friend's boat if you want. Then you can train together or compete or whatever you want. Your partner finds something interesting, make sure to check out the area. Oh my god. This is literally every loading screen tip. Yeah, I just dumped all at once. You get 2 kinds of requests here, guiding divers and taking pictures. You can take requests or ignore them, whatever you want. Good diving guides listen to their clients and show them what they want to see. Try to show clients other things too, though. Clients like guides who know their stuff. No one wants to spend any money with some person that just fell off the boat, right? If you want to be a super pro guide, you need to know the client's likes, dislikes, and hobbies, all of that, and pay attention to what interests them. And one more thing. These things, they bother me. One more thing. I'll get out of here. Don't lose to the client. That's a sure way to get a bad reputation. If you do get lost, I'll tell you where you can go find them. Okay. If you want to take good pictures, make sure the subject is framed in the center. Yes. Take a lot of pictures. Make friends with as many critters as you can. That's where we unlock their details in the encyclopedia. To pet things, hold down A with the Wii remote. Oh, okay, we've looped. Thank God. I've learned so much today, guys. Really good stream. I'll catch you again same time next week. We'll pick it up where we left off. Really, you know, fleshed out all the mechanics. Oh, did I? Did you see me, like, do the hand on my head? I'll get out of your hair. Yeah. I do that a lot. It's impressed on me from watching the TV show. I'll stumble around with just, like, one hand. I gotta align myself better. Like, one hand on my head like this, and I'm just like, oh, yeah. Oh, you know, these things, they bother me. Right now, it looks like I'm clawing out my eye sockets, because I'm actually about 5.5 feet away from my desk to get the Wii Remote to, like, do anything. Ah, okay, so one other thing. This game does support having a custom soundtrack, which is very cool, very progressive for the time. However, the SD card that I wanted to use is too big for the Wii. It is 64 gigabytes, and the Wii does not know what to do with it. So if you have any favorite water level music, please tweet it at me. I've got a couple prepared. I've got, like, Jolly Roger Bay from Mario, Hydrosity Zone from Sonic, the Donkey Kong water song, etc., etc. But I was going to play them tonight, but my SD card is simply too big. Are you playing with a real Wii remote? Yeah, absolutely, dude. This is being streamed off of my Nintendo Wii, which is why there were Miis from, like, 2007 on here. Yes, this is all on real hardware. SD card cannot be loaded, that's what I thought, yeah. Oh well. So I'll try and get a better SD card for next week, but just, if you've got cool water level songs, feel free to shoot around me. Gaze at the ocean. Why not sit a spell and enjoy the good life? So true. Can I, like, look around? No. Waggle motion doesn't do anything here. Okay, this game is game of the year for sure. Okay, so what was I supposed to do? I was supposed to enter the cabin and read my email. Yeah, the limit is 2 gigabytes for older titles. Yeah, I gotta go find a real small SD card. Hey, Fubal, welcome, welcome, welcome. This is our cap? Sure is. It's full of gear and maps and all that jazz. It's basically our nerve center. You need all this stuff eventually. But right now, you can only use the mobile device, dialogue, and clock. Can't use the book. Okay, cool. Let's look at my BlackBerry. I can save this. Yeah, it's been 2 whole years. Can you believe that? I also miss EverBlue. I miss it dearly. I don't know if this game will be as good. It might just be different. I don't like that I have to use a Wii remote. I would much rather just have buttons. I like the point-and-click navigation of EverBlue 2, where you could just use the D-pad to go from any point of interest to any other point of interest. But whatever, I'll get used to it, I'm sure. Time to read my email. Alfred Dorman, what do you got for me? From Alfred Dorman. Good day, my name is Alfred Dorman. Yes, I've inferred that from the subject line, greetings from Alfred Dorman. From Alfred Dorman. My name is Alfred Dorman. And I am the head of the Pelago branch for the Marianas. I'm going to keep calling it Marinara Foundation. Yeah, no, it's nice. I think they do a good job. I just don't like having to use a Wii remote. I'm not used to it anymore. So we hear your chief financial backer. If you're familiar with the coral forest, yes? We'd like you to perform a brief topographical inspection there. Simply dive to the coral forest and wait for the instructions from Catherine. There is no hurry on this. Please take some time to familiarize yourself with the NLIC before you go. Off your dormant. Alright, cool. They really emphasize that, like, you don't have to play the game quickly, I promise. Okay, cool. Catherine, I've read my email. Now what? Coral Forest is just west of here. Here's a map to help you complete topographical surveys. You can press 1 to view the map. I can now use a map, thank God. People say it's gorgeous. What, me? No, I've never been there. Why not? Oh, you know, I'm busy doing boat stuff, etc., etc. Oh, she can't swim, that's fun. She's like, EE from Metal Gear 2, or Metal Gear Solid 2. Can't swim. The glasses and everything. Like, it's just one of those things I want to talk about. I bet she had some kind of trauma where she almost drowned or something. Just like EE. Die. Oh, I can unlock music too. Oh, I can play the DMCA song again. I'll not do that. But there is music, it looks like, under the water this time. EverBlue did absolutely not have music underwater, except for one section at the very end, where they used the introduction of music, like, 20 hours in, as a real good way to get your attention. Do you know a lot about fish? They're kind of my specialty, so let me help you out. I can be your fish wisher. Fishburner. I can be your fishburner. Sorry, a lame joke. Anyway, fish take center stage in the ocean. Let me teach you how to examine a fish. Didn't we just go over this yet? You there. I kind of would prefer if this were first person, I think. There we go. Shark jingle. Yeah, I don't know if it's the same shark noise, though. I don't even know if sharks are scary. I can turn that back on. Oh no, I have to go find the sound file again. When I reformatted my hard drive, I lost it. I'll do that for the next stream. But I don't even know if the sharks in this game are dangerous. You focused on an animal. This is good. I'm always saying this about animals. When this happens, you'll automatically follow the animal and vote this. Okay. Next, you should view information on the critter. Press the bar on the lower portion of the screen to view information about the targeted creature. There we go. Once you become more familiar with this animal, you will learn more about it. Okay. We don't know anything about this guy. He's a total stranger. If you become more familiar with an animal, you will learn more about it. We have a special permission to work with animals. It's a pretty big honor, so treat them well. Try interacting with a fish. You can interact with creatures while they are in focus. Use the Wii remote to gently touch or pet them. Okay. So we learned that I can touch with A. And then I can pet. Or so they say. There we go. I've touched a fish, guys. Yeah, pet the fish. It looks like you are a natural at touching fish. You can also use food to get their attention. Food from the tools menu and try using it. Okay. Ah, a good old cloud of food. I guess that is accurate to fish food. Oh, they're so happy. They're glowing. They're going Super Saiyan. If you're kind and gentle to underwater creatures, you can become familiar with them. You may not even know what they're called in the beginning, but you'll learn tons of interesting things as you become familiar with them. Check on them often, okay? Can do. I can see that you know your way around. What? How did I know? I put a small video camera on your tank that lets me see everything. It's just for safety, of course, Silly. I'm not going to follow you around or anything. Anyway, the coral forest is west of here. I marked it on the map. You can check it with one. I want to pet more fish, though. I don't care about the coral forest. I'm uninterested in this. The breathing sound is definitely identical to the one from EverBlue, which I'm sure is just stock footage, or stock sound. But I would recognize this anywhere after, like, 25 hours of that game. Long-nosed butterfly fish. I'm petting the fish, guys. Oh, it's so happy. The fish loved it so much. That's not Kyogre. But I'm guessing it's some kind of water Pokemon. I don't think it's Kyogre. Maybe it is Kyogre. Oh, swing and a miss. Okay, Wailord. Thematically appropriate. So I guess there isn't music down here either. There was for like a minute, but not anymore. The other big fish, yeah. What have I learned? Okay. They are roughly 6 inches. It's a long-nosed butterfly fish. The Forsapinger flavissimus. These fish have narrow, elliptical bodies with extremely long mouths. Though mostly though, they sport a thick black band around the head and mouth. They can be seen year-round all over Manoloi. Okay. Cool. Alright, well, good stream, guys. We pet a fish. I'll catch you same time next week. We'll be all set. Now, what are you? You are a trigger fish, right? That's what they call you guys? Let me pet. I'm waggling this Wii remote like you wouldn't believe. Blue Tang, that's right. You should see. Oh, I think you can see how much I'm wiggling this Wii remote. I bet this is a great visual. Okay. What have we learned from petting the fish? Fish the business. Blue tang. Paracantharus apatus. Colorful blue tangs have narrow elliptical bodies. One of the most striking fish in all of Mount Olai. They are easily identified by their bright blue color and dark stripes and yellow tails. They can be found throughout Mount Olai during the summer. Cool. Instead of taking pictures of fish to learn more about them, you know, straight up giving him a massage while he gossips about his life, right? I think there is a camera as well. They were talking about taking photos, but one thing at a time. I do like this, though. This is way better than having to aim to take photos in EverBlue 2. I hated having to do that with the analog stick. It was very difficult. Emperor angelfish. Very cool. Gotta increase our social link. Length, 16 inches. He is Pomacanthus Imperator. Very cool. Emperor angelfish have narrow elliptical bodies. No kidding. Everybody's got this narrow elliptical body. Long dorsal fins. Their extremely colorful bodies are a combination of blues, blacks, and yellows, with the occasional hints of orange. They're frequently seen in Mount Olai during the summer. Wonder how we'll be with the aggressive ones. We'll see. We will learn. What are you? I mean, you're a manta ray, but do I know that yet? Clearly not. Alright, manta ray, tell me your secrets, manta ray. Length, roughly 16 feet. Manta, birostris. Manta style. These fish have thin bodies, not elliptical, with long diamond shapes, large mouths, and narrow tails. Their back portions are black, while their bellies are white, with black spots. They can be seen all over Mount Olai at any time of the year. Now, they told me I could, like, hitch a ride, is that right? Do I have to, like, do something? Oh, there is a first person, okay. We're playing this game in first person until I get motion sick, which might be very soon. This is much more how I would expect this kind of game to play. Map. See, I guess I can't ride the manta ray. Do I want anything else? Okay. So we need to go west. Oh, but there's more fish. I haven't learned about all these guys yet. Pyramid... Oh, they were really ready to tell me about themselves. Pyramid butterfly fish. Hemitorachythus polylepis. Okay. Hemitorachythus polylepis. Length roughly 6 inches. Yo, you'll never believe it, guys. They've got narrow elliptical bodies. Give it up for narrow elliptical body havers. Conical mouths. They're colored in a variety of browns, yellows, and whites. It can be seen all over Mount Olai year-round. Love to hear it. Big fan of elliptical bodies. I think that's, like, the ideal body type. Okay, we wanted to go west. We're going west. What are you? I have to know every fish. Green chromy? Chromy viridis? 3 inches? Narrow spindle-shaped bodies with two pronged tails. Despite the name, they're actually more of a blue-green color. Easy to spot. They can be found year-round. Wow. This game's already lying to me. They're not green. Chromis. Chromis. Alright, and then a shark comes out of nowhere and kills me, right? Is that a parrotfish? You there. Parrotfish. State your name. Am I on the money? Oh, bicolor parrotfish. This parrotfish is bi. Very cool. Cetoscarus and bicolor. Bicolor parrotfish. These fish have narrow, spindle-shaped bodies with round heads. They're mostly blue with hints of peach on the edges of their fins. They can be seen year-round. So this is all cool, this surface-level information, where I'm like, ah, yes, this fish that I've seen, it's the color that you see it. I want to learn the deep lore. I need to know the deepest secrets of these fish. But I guess that's what we're here for. Oh, and we're at the coral forest, I suppose. very good. This is the coral forest. It's just like the name says. The coral grows here like a majestic underwater forest. Ah, dolphin. I need to go talk to the other parrotfish, though. I don't have time for that. Yeah, I think you're right. I gotta use the camera. I gotta remember how to do that. Maybe using other items. Dolphin must have been separated from his pod, or was playing a prank. Dolphins are known pranksters, I wouldn't be surprised. Never had a dolphin make fun of me before, that was great. Anyway, we're done researching the terrain. I literally just got here. I can dive for my leisure. Head back to the Gabbiano when you get tired. Alright. Do I have to go after that dolphin? Is that like the hook for the next quest? I need to go talk to this really big fish. Humphead Rass is what I think this thing is called. I might be wrong, though. Let's see. Sir? Can we pay you? Sir? Oh, man. Am I good or what? I'm the fish knower. After EverBlue and, like, my general background with, like, ecology, I think I just know every fish. Humphead Rass, I was on the money. But, 7 feet. Calinus undulatus, interesting name. Slow, curious fish have large elliptical bodies with a bump-like protrusion on their head. They're usually a striking color, blue-green color, although other shades have been reported. This fish can be seen year-round. Alright, so let's see if I can remember how to do anything. From the boat, food. I read all those tutorial tips, but I don't remember how to use the camera. I thought it was the button that I'm currently using. Is it plus? Minus? No. 2 is point of view. 1 is map. Oh, that's the zoom. Well, I pressed every button on... Have I played Abzu? No, I haven't. There's that one, and there's, I think, Endless Blue or something like that that came out, which is another educational game that I kind of want to give a whirl. There are going to be so many Octobers, so... I mean, there's Endless Ocean 2 after this one. Very cool. I'm glad this is a genre of game that there is more than one of. I'll be very impressed if any of them dethrone EverBlue as, like, my premier diving RPG. We'll see. Also, if first person makes you guys, like, motion sick or whatever, please just let me know. I'm not married to playing it this way. It's just how I'm used to it from EverBlue. But I can go back to third person if it's better. Are you a trigger fish? I don't remember what you're called. You were also seen in Finding Nemo. I just don't remember what your species is. I'm failing. Moorish idol. The sound we just heard was like probably a phoebus or something. I don't know. That was a grody noise. I wouldn't think that's a fish if not for context. Moorish idol. Tell me about Moorish idol. Moorish idol. Zanclus cornutus. Cornutus. 10 inches. These eye-catching fish have elliptical bodies. Give it up for elliptical bodies. I'm so stoked to know how many fish have elliptical bodies. They're almost as narrow as they are tall, with a large dorsal fin that tapers to a narrow spine. They also have yellow and white markings and are crossed by a black... Yeah, we know what they look like. I don't know why I'm reading all of these. It's like, they're just describing the fish. It's the level 2... Oh, Magikarp, okay. That's what it was. I was close. I'm getting so close with these, and yet still so far. You're also some kind of ras, right? Even though you're really small. I remember you guys in EverBlue, too. I remember finding you in the ferry, I'm pretty sure. What are you? Samurai Squirrelfish. Okay, I don't know what they are. Isn't Samurai Squirrel like a Hanna-Barbera cartoon? That's a crazy scientific name. Sargossantron? That sounds completely faked. Itodai. Though the name is impressive, these fish resemble neither samurai nor squirrels. Instead, they have long, narrow bodies. Not elliptical, though. With 2 prolonged tail fins and a bright red body. They also both striking white markings, etc., etc. It is a great name, right? Samurai Squirrelfish? It sounds like a Hanna-Barbera cartoon. Now, you're a yellow tang, right? Surely you must be a yellow tang. There we go. My favorite TMNT knockoff, right? Yeah, elliptical bodies, etc., etc. When I introduce myself to someone going forward, I think I'm going to talk about how elliptical my body is or isn't. That's my plan. Okay. Here's where I get killed by a shark. Any moment now. That's the place from the opening. We've been here before. Yeah, so Goshentron sounds like a, like a Mazinger type robot. I agree. Oh, we got music again. That's cool. We're allowed to have audio. Mammals do love sounds, after all. Okay, you're a triggerfish. I won't be made a fool of the third time. You are absolutely a triggerfish. Kind of ominous music, actually. Clown triggerfish. Please let me click. 14 inches, elliptical body, etc., etc. Cool, cool, cool. This music does feel very ominous, right? Like, I'm not crazy, right? The thimble of Mele Patua. Okay. What do you think of the soundtrack? I mean, there is music, which is cool. That's a step up from EverBlue 2, which only had music in the overworld. But we've already met the Chromies. I can feed them that. Oh, I only have 8 things of food left. Fool that I am. Okay. Well, we'll learn more about the Chromie someday later. Ooh. Are you also some kind of tang? Striped tang? I don't know. You look like the yellow tang. Sailfin tang. Now that's an elliptical body if ever I've seen one. Wide elliptical bodies. Very cool. And they're also saying that you can poke your head out from the top, right? Which is a thing you definitely couldn't do in, Oh, wow, oh! There's, like, stuff up here. Three-dimensional navigation, I would never expect it. Powder blue tang. Every flavor of tang under the sun. I think we've got them now. They can't possibly make any more tang than this. Yeah? Didn't they say I could look around? No? I'm pressing every button on my controller. I'm auto-swimming to God. I thought they said I could, like, look around. Topside. I'll have to go reread Catherine's entire tutorial tooltip. Alright, well, we'll figure that out. I don't have any particular mission. I should probably just go back to the boat and progress the story. Wrong button. What are my options also? What are expert controls? Control has no angle limitation. I'm good, thanks. That sounds like a really good way to get motion sick. Yeah, yeah. So this game supports using custom soundtrack while you dive, I guess because it doesn't have one for most of the time you're underwater. But the SD card that I have that I prepared with music from water levels that I sourced from people on Twitter is too big, unfortunately. The Wii cannot read it because it is 64 gigabytes. So I have to go and find a baby SD card that would have been appropriate for 2007. for next time. That's my bad. I should have done my homework a little bit better before the stream. I just really didn't have time. But yeah, so I think I've got like the water level from Donkey Kong, some Mario 64 water levels, some Sonic stuff, Mega Man, I think is in here. If you've got a favorite water level soundtrack, please tweet it at me. I will have it ready for next week, I promise. One way or another, I will get an SD card that is small enough. Bro, imagine the crazy... it's just music, dude. I could emulate that right now by playing the MP3s over the stream, but it would be inauthentic, so I won't. But I could also just play the EverBlue soundtrack over this one and be like, this is all's right in the world. Well, I'm going to go in this cave here, and I'm going to say return to boat while I'm in a cave. I think that seems just. Gabbiano means seagull in Italian. Cool, I've charted out more of the world. I do like the Gabbiano music. Penguin! Oh! Hey, look! Penguin! Little Penguino. What a cutie, huh? He came to say hi. I met these guys yesterday when I was at the zoo. I saw a bunch of these. Though it was an African penguin. They're native to the southern coast of Africa. So true. There are a few that hang out on Mauna Loa too. Do you know what the colloquial name for this penguin is? They couldn't say it in this game because this game is rated E for everyone. With no disclaimer on the back from the... That's actually really interesting. I'm looking at my case for this game, and where there would be like the ESRB rating on the back of the case, there's just a white box. That's very interesting. That's strange. But yeah, this game is rated E for everyone. For sure, for sure. And so they could not tell you that the colloquial name for this animal is the jackass penguin, because it sounds like a braying donkey with the noise it makes. You can interact with animals on your boat by pressing and pointing A. Wow! You there, penguin. I must interact with you. I can interact with you to increase my level of familiarity. We're going crazy over here. Get my reps in. I gotta make this penguin love me. It's important. It's the only thing that matters. I gotta wear the heart rate monitor for the stream next time now that I know it's got such intense waggle controls. He's sparkling so much, I'm switching arms. Do the sparkles mean that I'm increasing the social bond, or is it just like every couple reps? This is crazy, I'm going ballistic over here. Yeah, I know what you mean. Alright, African penguin, what's up? How do I learn more about you? Meniscus demersus. 2 feet. These birds have spindle-shaped bodies, not elliptical at all. I think it's very funny that they use the same language that they would describe the fish with. Their coloring is mostly black and white, but they have a more complicated pattern than seen on other penguins. The area around their eyes is pink because of a small flap of exposed skin. It may appear on your boat from time to time. Can I click on the two? No. Those are still unavailable. No. That's why I'm just going ballistic with them. So I assume we'll get other tools soon, like where the hand is here. I assume that will be an option that I can have. But gosh, I just want to pet this penguin. It's so important to me that he loves me and he comes back. I can't use the food up here. I'm sure that I just have to, like, use other tools or something. Look how happy he is. It's like he's saying, hold on, he's saying, I like you, I'm gonna come back with all of my friends. You don't speak penguin? What do you mean? Yes, I know what animals are saying. I'm not like other girls, I can speak to animals. I've been studying marine biology my whole life. All it takes is a lot of careful observation and experience. Just look at their faces and then... I don't know. It's as much intuition as anything else. Let's talk about something else. Did I tell you I'm writing the marine biology encyclopedia? Very good. But maybe you'd like to help out. The more you can learn, the better the encyclopedia will be. Try to learn new stuff, okay? You need to get familiar with marine life to fill the encyclopedia. I'm trying my best out here. It's waiting in the cabin, so take a look when you feel like it. I am trying my best. I forgot something else. I think the penguin distracted me. That was some nice work down there. It's a lot of ocean to cover outside the lagoon, right? Look, it's okay. I can tell you're one of those types with ambition. So you're gonna get tired of the lagoon before long. But don't worry, the Gabbiano can take you if you want. Just sail to the new area and start diving from that point. I made an extra key for you. I'm a pilot, too! I'm a sailor. Gonna go take a nap, so I almost forgot. That key I gave you? You can also open the Nintendo Wi-Fi gate. I bet I can't do that anymore. You can use it to visit a friend or let them visit you. There's no town here, as far as I know. Make friends? Say hi for me, okay? Nintendo Wi-Fi connection gate is open. I have new mail. It would be crazy if the Wi-Fi still worked in this game, though. I would absolutely be excited to let people come by. Yeah, we saw this already. Oh. Encyclopedia. This is, I'm assuming, all of the info we just found. Now, I will say these are probably the best-looking fish on the Wii. I can't imagine there's a game with better rendered fish. Okay. Octopus. Now, this to me looks very much like the octopus model and the lobster model that were in EverBlue. I would not be surprised if they're direct ports, and like, because the Wii is barely a higher res console than the PS2, I would not be surprised if they were just the same. It's also interesting that they show all of these fish in here. I guess kind of spoilers for you, maybe later. Lots of rockfish. Sea slugs, exciting. Sea stars. Sea dragons. Seahorses. Squids of various types. Garden eels, I'm guessing. Spider crab. Anglerfish, Getty crab, humphead rasp, barracuda. And now we got some sharks, some kind of shark, hammerhead, whale shark? Wow, a lot of sharks. Manta ray, sea turtle, yes. And then the baby sharks, like nurse sharks and what have you. Sawfish. Sturgeon, or marlin, rather. This is an interesting looking creature. Now that's a whale. This is definitely a whale, right? Oh, the tail looks wrong for it to be a whale. I don't know. This is maybe some kind of eel. I don't know what the hell this thing is. This is like a moray eel. This is a wobegong. I don't know. Viperfish. Mola Mola. King Crab. Very cool. Who knows? There's a lot of creatures in here. Wow, even more sharks. Goblin sharks are back. That's cool. Whoa! Ribbon fish. I don't know what this thing is. That's a coelacanth. Big squid. Vampire squid, I think. Gulper eel, I think is what this is called. Sea pig. Nautilus. Dolphins. Dolphins, etc. Big whale, less big whale. Sperm whale, wow. Humpback whale. Seals? I guess they can maybe call out your boat. Wow. There are so many critters in this game. That looks like a polar bear or a bear of some kind. That's an iguana. And multiple species of penguin. Wow. There's so many more animals in this game. That's incredible. I look forward to meeting them all. Anyway, we got more mail. Oh, everybody wants to talk to me. Let's talk about my blue hole. Holy cow. Blue Holes is a massive rock formation housing many small caves. Divers are treated to views like no other from beams of light that pour in from the openings overhead. At one time, this formation was above ground, but rising oceans and erosion have gradually created the formations we see today. Due to complex tidal flows, items will sometimes drift into blue holes, including some truly rare objects. That's all for now. Okay. Following up. This is Alfred Thorman again. I take things that went well for your survey. Good job. There are many unexplored areas. In fact, I wanted to mention a spot to the south known as the Blue Holes. Rare items. It's, yay, I know, Alfred. Thank you. I read my email. Towers of Power. If you only make one dive on your trip, dive here. The coral forest is Mount Ila's prominent grouping for coral reefs. A myriad of coral towers literally sparkle in sunlight. In the sunlight-pierced waters. Cool. Yes, and the lagoon. Interesting. I can sell it anywhere on the map, huh? Just really just fucking go anywhere, huh? On land? Wow, I can just go, huh? I can just go. See a boat. Where are we now? The sun's going down. You can't go down diving, not yet anyway. You don't have that proper equipment. Why not call today? You can catch some Z's in the cabin. Did I take the penguin with us all the way over here? It does seem simple, yeah. It's because it lets you... Oh, we did take the penguin with us. It lets you have more freedom from the outset, which I think makes it seem like it's laying all of its systems bare, which it might be. But you couldn't do this in EverBlue, so who's to say which is the better game? Yeah, like, for all I know, there might be a mainland that we get to. They were talking about the mainland aquarium. There might be more to it than that. Did you find that rare thing in Blue Holes? It's evening already, so you can go diving tomorrow. Okay. They want us to go to Blue Holes. See ya, penguin. How do I go to sleep? Do I just advance time? Rest until morning, yes. Penguin's still here. That's a huge win. There's enough light to go diving now. We're going to the blue holes. I think. Well, I'm over here. I don't know where here is. They just said it was down south. So let's see what we've got over here. There doesn't seem to be a depth gauge, which is interesting. I guess maybe that's just not a mechanic anymore. In EverBlue, you'd get crushed if you went out too far until you got better gear, because it's like an RPG. I don't really know what to expect for this one. Oh. Immediate cutscene. Oh. Rock bluff. Wow. They got like trees down here. Yeah, I don't know. I really don't know what to expect. I don't think this game is going to be as scary as EverBlue was to me. Just because, one, I'm, like, mentally stronger now. I've been fortified by EverBlue. But also, I just, like, think this game is really just, like, pet every fish. I say as I dive into the gorge here. Like, my UI is very minimal. It's just a compass. But looking at the open ocean still fills me with a sense of dread, even when it's, like, the most hand-holdy game imaginable. When I just look off and there's just... just blue. And I can't see that far. There is no oxygen bar. They did tell me I couldn't be down here forever, but I don't see a bar that indicates otherwise. So maybe that was just fluff and flavor text. Oh, okay, there's my air gauge. And my, there is depth gauge. Okay, it's just hidden most of the time. Interesting. Or is that a depth gauge? I'm leaving the... Okay, okay. That's how they... I see. Okay, so... I can only go so far from the boat. That makes sense. Otherwise... Because in EverBlue, you can go across the entire map. But I guess because this game is on a... basically the same level of hardware, but has a bit more to it. You can only go out so far. Interesting. I don't think it's a depth gauge. I think it's a distance from the boat gauge. I'm not sure. That one thing is for certain, though, there are just no fish here. I found the part of the ocean where there aren't fish. Oh, there's one fish. But who cares? We already know about this guy. Don't even give a damn. We already know about you, right? Long-nosed butterfly fish. Can't imagine a more hurtful thing to call somebody than a long-nosed butterfly fish. Delicious. Fog, delicious. Particle effects, my favorite. Yum, 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 yum. Very good. Yeah, so, like, I don't really like looking at the open ocean. Even if I know I'm, like, maybe safe, probably. It still just doesn't fill me with the good vibes. Now would be really an opportune time for that shark sound redeem. You're so right, Fubal. You're so right. I'll have to have that for next time. Okay, actually, the distance number only ever seems to... Oh, no, it went back down. I don't know. Okay, well, there doesn't seem to be anything of interest over here. At least not yet. So we're gonna go back to the boat. The red symbol is the icon of the boat. It's a little sailboat. Which made me think it's your distance from the boat rather than your depth. But I could be wrong. Cool. I think it was depth, though, because it said our record depth was 104 feet. I have new mail, wow. Did the penguin bring his friends back? Diving guide request. Yeah, let's do it. Aubrey Thorman, I handle the request for diving guides in the region. I have a request for you. The client's name is Will Gain. He's a pretty valued client. Treat him really nice. He wants to dive in the coral for us. There's no fixed date, but let us know when you're available. Yeah, let's go. Oh, Blue Holes is marked on the map. Cool. So he wants to go to the coral forest. We're gonna go here. Alright, here's our guy, here's our man. What's up, Will Gain? Thanks for being my guide, my name is Will Gain. Since we're in Mount Isla, I'd love to see a humphead rasp. Boy, do I have the guy for you then. I've gone as deep as 60 feet, but I don't really want to go any deeper. That's fair. Okay, so this is how this game works then. Interesting. Who needs to salvage for money when you can just do the diving thing for money? That makes a lot of sense. You find a creature you want to show a client, focus on it, and get the client's attention. Okay. You find a creature requested by a client, show it off, it'll make them very happy. And you're a parrotfish. Diving with you makes me happy to be alive. Wow. This game will not end before the end of the month. There is no way I finish this game in 3 weeks, in 3 play sessions. There is zero chance. So the answer to your question is no. I expect this will probably not even be done by the end of November. Like, we are currently an hour and a half in, right? And I've done one story beat of the tutorial. Who are you? Get back here. The Sea of Mount Isla is our planet's treasure, don't you think? Can you hear me? Is everything going well? You haven't found- I know. Relax. Oh yeah, I mean, Grim Pandango is in November. We're playing year 3 on Day of the Dead for sure. That'll be Wednesday, November 1st, if I have anything to say about it. That's technically November, but also, yeah. We'll be doing the next year of that game. Yes, that's on the cards. I have to cut a recap video for people who weren't there and don't have encyclopedic memory of what I did literally one full calendar year ago to the day. I'm gonna make a little recap for what happened in year 2. Yeah, there's our boy, there's our fish. I can't believe it! We found it! Is everything over? The client seems pretty happy. You can come up whenever. Fish located. I need that FromSoft text where it's like, fish discovered. Fish located. Have I learned anything new about the humped rest, though? I have! That's exciting. Females differ from males in that their head protrusions are smaller and their bodies are a whitish color. Young fish also have two black lines behind their eyes. These fish are highly territorial and usually live alone in coral-covered areas. However, larger numbers can be often seen congregating during spawning season. So cool. Well, that's enough of that, I think. Unless I can get more information out of other fish now. You there. I am free from gravity. It feels so cool. What a guide you are. Do you have any new information for me? You do. So maybe I just have to come back on multiple days. Juveniles and adults have different spot patterns. Juveniles have a whirlpool-shaped pattern of white, blue, and deep blue. As the fish grows, they gradually turn into... this gradually turns into a pattern of vertical lines. No, I just got one from a different unrelated fish. I think you just have to come back on multiple days. You probably can't get them all in one go. I wish I could tell my friends back home about how I feel right now. Yeah, I hope so. Like, this guy's gonna sparkle again in a second. There we go. And it makes the little sound effect, which indicates that we have unlocked another piece of trivia. Males, females, and fry are all different in color. Fry are white with an orange stripe around their heads, while females are yellow and black around the edges of their scales. Cool. Wowee. I certainly have no intention to 100% this game, but cool, that's how that works. And they said we can go back up whenever, so we might as well do that. I can't wait to tell my friends about this. Cool. I'm glad you feel that way. We are leaving. We've managed to avoid drowning, so that's good. That was amazing. I can't believe you're so new at this. Listen, I want to give you something as a thank you. Wow, thanks, dude. I have a pen. I can write. Finally, I can record all the fish talk. Prototype that's being developed at my company. It uses light-emitting particles to stimulate hydrogen molecules so they express... never mind. It's a pen that works underwater. Cool, I could just use a pencil. They call it a water pen. Name needs a little work, huh? Anyway, you can use it to mark locations or write notes to friends. Yeah, I mean, EverBlue is a little bit more, I think, explicit in how you 100% it. But we will see. Gotta get going. Hope you can show me around again sometime soon. I give him the A-OK. Wow, I have a pen now. That's so cool. Any critters on deck? No? Oh. Seeing how ponderous the gameplay of this game is, though, I do wonder what the speedrun is. Like, what the time is. I can play dress up. I guess this is how I got the hair. Cool. driftwood suit, dolphin BCD, blue gloves, beluga blue fins, and battleship. So this is all cosmetic, okay. EverBlue is all about progressing to get better equipment, and it doesn't seem like that's the case here. Very interesting. Explore the rock bluff. Yeah, 1 second, let me read the rest of my email. Oh, he sent me a scuba tank or suit over email. I'd love to download new clothes from my email account. Yeah, let's pop that on as a, I guess, a trophy. Ooh, that's hideous. I love it. Yeah, I have no idea what the goal is right now. Did we just do a bunch of diving requests? EverBlue is like, get money, stop the evil company from upending the ocean, get the MacGuffin, and put it back in its place in the bottom of, what was it, Telospolis, or whatever it's called? The underground, underwater temple. Very, very linear. I'm Karina Ortez, the famous Spanish designer. Cool, okay. She's terribly well known. We've all heard of her, after all. Emperor Angelfish. If I could see that, I would never forget it. Well, I've got just the guy for you. I love that this guy always does the hand signal. It's great. Be the Indiana Jones of the Sea, plus a bit of Robin Hood towards the townsfolk. Yes, you're so right. And here I'm just like, let me point and click at a fish with the Wii remote. Very zen, I do like it. Emperor Angelfish spotted. Mission accomplished. Fish located. Wait. Wii remote, please. Oh my god. Fish? Sir. There we go. Golly. Fighting the controls every step of the way. Learn more about the Emperor English, if we can. It's so happy. Okay, but it's not making any noise, so I don't think I'm actually learning anything new. Oh yeah, and the guy told me he gave me a pen, right? Can I use that? Like, underwater pen. This will be a memorable dive. What does that do? What, this will be a memorable dive? Or the soundtrack? What do you mean? So I hit OK, what does this do? Oh, you can like write stuff in three. I guess this is if you have the Wi-Fi. Interesting, I just wrote on the water. You can draw underwater, yeah. If I were a good artist, that would be fun. I thought that was a whale right there and not my boat. I got really excited. But that is in fact my boat. Alas. Think of what they took from us when they shut down WFC. I wonder if we'll ever be able to talk to them one day. Well, our girl Catherine says she can talk to animals. So that's cool. Alright, Sailfin Tang, what have we learned? There's a movable spine at the base of this tail fin that is used to guard against predators. The coloration of juveniles is different from that of an adult, with young fish having more of a yellowish tinge. Wow. This will be a memorable dive. Well, we already found the Emperor Angelfish, so can't get any better than that. And yeah, you're saying you like the music in this game, but it stops after like 12 seconds of being underwater. I don't really understand why they've made that decision. Any other critters out here? Really kind of devoid of fish out in the rock bluff. Weird that they would want to encourage the MP3 thing. Whatever. Back to the boat. Thanks to you, I've rediscovered why I love to dive. I'm heading back now. Thanks for your help today. I can't wait to get a Humphead Rass-inspired shirt. And once again, we give him the A-OK. Well, yeah, like, so EverBlue only had music in the overworld, and it was really bumping overworld music. And then when you got underwater, there was nothing. And the only time, the one singular time, there was music underwater was when you approached the, like, Chaos Emerald. It was in a locked room in a submarine, and you couldn't find where it was until you got close enough to it that you hear music fade in, and you're like, oh, something is happening. Which was very, very cool. But here, there's, like, music whenever you want it. So I don't know. Hey, look who's back. Look who came crawling back. What have we learned about you today, African penguin? These birds have spindle shape, They usually lay two fertilized eggs, the first of which is slightly larger. Smaller eggs are laid at the same time, but are unfertilized and will not hatch. Why would they do that? Why? Very cool. Okay, so it looks like you can probably get one fact out of an animal per day. So you have to see them at least three times to get everything. That makes sense. Okay, they want me to go to blue holes. Yeah, I hope someday that I can just have the whole penguin colony on my boat. That would be ideal. Kino even. Save. Okay, so if I go to the encyclopedia here, I flip to the end and look at my birds. Can I, like, look at them in more detail? No. Alas. Well, quite a diversity of penguins they've got here. That's cool. Oh, they want me to go to blue holes? Let's go. I do like that we take the boat out and the penguins just stay. Like, this seems very irresponsible to move them from where they came from. But I guess we're not going that far. So now I'll learn how to pick up stuff out of the ocean floor. And that'll be the next mechanic, and then we'll have all of the mechanics that we talked about in the tutorial. I disagree. I would be terrified to do this. I do not think people belong in the ocean. I still believe this. I very much believe this to be true. I don't think that there's any place for a human being underwater. We are not designed for it, and we are making mockeries of God and disobeying what was intended for us by attempting this. Ayo? I'm in that hole? I just remembered something. Some kind of precious object. Why don't you try looking for it? Okay. It's probably in one of these god rays, right? Okay. Very hand-holdy. Oh. Hold on, that's really good. Let me see if I can get that sound on the Wii again. It came out of the Wii remote. I doubt you could hear it. Yeah? Okay, that's enough of that, huh? That's fun. Look at that! It's a dolphin medal for being good at dolphin. I'm gonna interact with the small fish. Three spot decilus. These fish have narrow, light blue bodies with arrow-shaped fringe on their tail. They can be seen year-round in the coral reefs. Very cool. I got the dolphin medal for being good at dolphin. First place in dolphin. There he is. This is his medal. Take a chance. Hey, brother. And he's out of there. Hated it. The vibes are just off. So I can press plus now and like stare at the ocean floor, which is kind of cool. Like at the zoom view, they call it, which is neat. Speaking of, like, tiny fish that you might otherwise miss, I was at the aquarium earlier this month in our area, and they had a feeding program that they were doing, and they have this giant coral reef tank that has, like, 700 fish in it, and during the feeding program, they were talking about how there's this one tiny little guy, some kind of cowfish, and they had to feed him separately in his own little box, because he was too shy, and the other fish were taking food from him, and he got too nervous to eat when he was around other fish. So, in this whole big tank, the keepers noticed that there was one fish that was not getting an adequate amount of food, and they have like a little quarantine box for him, and I think that's the most adorable thing. I know guys here. Now I have to like inspect every flat surface. Because you never know where there might be a guy that I would otherwise miss. I think it was some kind of cowfish. Hey, what are you? You're a shark. Shark spotted, nice. Lemon shark? Nurse shark? One of these? Lemon shark? Cat shark? It's Gawagura. Cloudy cat shark. Skylorhinus torrisae. These fish have long, narrow bodies, broad heads, and short snouts. They're generally brown. Very cool. Alright, sharks found, and they didn't even try and kill me. Though these guys are not very aggressive IRL either, I don't believe. Yeah, I wonder how many different little vignettes for zooming in there are. Because so far we've seen quite a few. Can I lure somebody out of their tiny little hole? No? Surely there's got to be a little guy in there, right? Oh, well, I'll have to come back with better gear. That's what I'm thinking, right? Crab or some kind of eel? You still a cat shark? Yeah. Oh! Big Ham! Hey! Welcome! How's it going, Big Ham? Big Ham mentioned large gaming hamster on twitch.tv. How's it going? It's good. Nice, nice, nice. So I'm kicking off October right now, playing the sequel to one of my favorite PlayStation games. Yeah, yeah, Brazil mentioned. Big Ham's a Brazilian gaming hamster on twitch.tv, large gaming hamster. Very talented artist. All around good hamster. Good character. Good person. So yeah, welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm Skeletom. I'm your undead host this evening. I'm currently playing the sequel to one of my favorite PlayStation games that I played two Octobers prior, called EverBlue, which is a diving RPG on the PlayStation 2. If you're interested in that, please check out my VODs channel, because that game kicked ass. I got it when I was a real little kid, and it scared the shit out of me, because it's like, oh, peaceful diving like we're doing right now, and then you go out a little too far, and a shark beelines for you, and it plays the Jaws stinger, and you get mauled by a shark, and you get killed. And so I was very, very frightened of it, and then I remember very clearly when I played that game, I immediately returned it the next day, and then never thought about it again. And then I was like, okay, cool, I'm a streamer now, what should I do? Ooh, hold on, there's something here. For October, let's play EverBlue. And I played it again, and I fell in love with it. It is a, diving RPG for the PlayStation 2 from Arika, who are the people you might know from, like, I don't know, Tetris Grandmaster, and, Street Fighter EX, and like I think they've worked on Tetris 99 and Mario 35 and games like that. But for a brief stint in the early 2000s, they made not one, not two, not three, but four diving RPGs for the PlayStation 2 and Wii. And I couldn't tell you why they kept making them, because they were all like critically panned commercial flops. But I really liked EverBlue 2. It was very cool. It was all about salvaging. Somebody off the team must really like diving. I couldn't tell you why, but that seems to be what they're all about. Okay, we found some funny little fish guys. We gotta pet them. This game is all about petting fish. EverBlue 2 is about salvaging stuff off the ocean floor to, you know, like, get money, get better diving gear so you can go out further and deeper, exploring shipwrecks and things like that. Really recommend checking out the VODs. They're all timestamped and everything on my VODs channel, which you can access probably on the links below if I had to see it. But this one seems to just be about just the exploration. It's on the Wii, so it's all about waggle controls, like I'm just petting fish. You'll see me going, like, crazy with the shake weight sometimes, just because of the nature of the beast. But I digress. Thank you for the raid. What were you up to, by the way? I didn't even ask. That was very inconsiderate of me. Let me give you the... Yeah, I can wave to you. I've got the big hand tracking, so I can be like, 1, 2, 3... A-okay. Radical, yeah. Making 3D caterpillar hammy. That sounds like an abomination. Some kind of affront to God, perhaps? I'm not sure. Really, whatever depravity you got up to is between him and you. But I will give you the shout-out regardless. The large gaming hamster. Does that not work? Do I not have my cloud bot on? That's fine. Big Ham. What's that? What happened? Oh, thank you for the follow. Thanks for the joining the skeleton crew. They got a saying here in the digital underworld, which is if it doesn't read rest in peace on your tombstone, you get drafted into the skeleton war. So I gotta really thank you from the bottom of my, or metaphorical heart in this case, for voluntarily enlisting. You are saving me from needing to draft some poor sucker into the underlife, or afterlife, sorry. Undertow in the afterlife. Oh, and check this out. We found cat sharks It's what they based Gawagura on. Hold on, I gotta now back way the hell away from my desk after I use my keyboard. I'm doing this entire stream like 5+ feet from my desk because of the Wii remote. It's a cat shark. Real Gawagura, yeah. Yeah, this game seems pretty chill. I just did a mission where I got a medal. I got a gold medal in Dolphin. It's Gooba. I mean, this is what she's up to when she's not streaming, I assume. That's very cool. So what's your plan for the 3D caterpillar model that you're making? Because I can't even imagine a single use case for that, other than just proving that you can do it. To, again, exert hubris over the divine creator. Just upon render, okay. So is it rigged, or is it just a render? That's my question. Just a render. Gotcha. That's fun. It's nice to be an artist. That sounds enjoyable. If you find stuff in the ocean, I'll put it in your footlocker. Okay. If we learn anything about the items, you can check on that too. We donate most finds to the local museum. They'd love us there. I can now use the footlocker. So if this were EverBlue 1, or EverBlue 2 rather, I would immediately take the stuff I found and return to the auction house, which had the most jamming music, like, on Earth. But here it looks like we just get to hold on to it and keep it. Way more about exploring than it is about that hustle and grind. Yeah, Big Ham is a Big O enjoyer, which is another reason that they're very cool. I should have led with that, actually. Metal engraved for the dolphin and a laurel leap. There's the inscription, 16th Annual Drift Dive Champion. Metal and dolphin. We still have penguins on top deck? Please? No. They've abandoned us. We've been forsaken. Alright, into the cabin we go. They'll be back with more friends later. Yeah, I hope so. Alright, can I download any more clothes from my PDA, my BlackBerry here? New gloves, yes. Alfred Dorman coming in clutch. Hey, it's Alfred Dorman again. You're doing an exceptional job out there. Everyone at the Foundation thinks more and more of you by the day. To reward your efforts, I'm sending you some new equipment. I am sure it will be put to good use, Alfred Dorman. Now I can download some gloves from my email. Very nice. I'm gonna look so ugly. Bill has given your performance 4 out of 5 stars. He was very happy with the experience you provided, and pleased with Foundation, etc. Soon I'll be a top guy. Wow. 3 out of 5 stars. Okay, I guess I gotta stick around longer. When you, like, do good enough, they just say you can go up at any time you're done. You found the fish they wanted to see. But, I guess I need to stick around a little bit longer underwater. But hey, we can download some new gloves. Let's do that. Beautiful. An hour. I kind of just want to go to, like, the opposite side of the world, since you can just do that in this one. Until it becomes too dark to dive. Oh yeah, also Big Ham and Raiders and such, while you're here, do y'all have a favorite water level? Like, from any video game? It can be, you know, a platformer, it can be the sinking strut from Metal Gear Solid 2, anything that constitutes a water level. If you've got a favorite one, sound off in the chat, because I need to harvest music to use in my future streams for this game, because as you might notice, the underwater sections are very hauntingly silent. Ooh, wow. You weren't kidding about finding a whale. Chemical Plant Zone 2 is, I guess, technically a water level. I've got Hydrosity queued up, and I think I have one of their Sonics on. Metroid Fusion, okay. I'll keep that in mind. I might decide to become your partner. We're gonna marry a dolphin, guys. We're gonna enter a domestic partnership with this pod of, dolphins. As soon as I can remember how to turn around. Alright, where the fuck were they? Oh, okay. We are gonna marry the shit out of this dolphin. Hey, bud. You're heavily impeded by the water the first time you arrive, and Lady Boothier quite gracefully. Isn't that nice? Commerce in this dolphin. Let's learn about this guy. These mammals have small, spindle-shaped bodies and are slightly rounded dorsal fins. White, black in color, these curious animals can be seen all around. At the Moya. Dick Force Delta! That's a name I haven't seen in a while. I remember reading your name in chat quite a while ago because it's very memorable. Probably during an EverBlue stream, now that I think about it. I haven't had to say that out loud in a hot minute. Welcome back, Dick Force. Nice to see you. There's also dev-intended sequence breaks in there that give you special dialogue words to say, hey, that's cute, but you're breaking the story, please turn around. That's funny. Yeah, I got the Donkey Kong aquatic song in here. Right, how do I make the dolphins like me? I need to marry a dolphin, guys. What do I do? Are they interested in this? I just draw, like, a hoop? They think that's the cool shit in the world? They're impressed? No? That's okay. We'll come back to them. Okay, yeah, other people remember the username Dick Forest Delta too, right? It's very memorable. I haven't been on Twitch in a while. Well, I'm flattered that you came back just for little old me. I'm assuming that's the only reason why and there's nothing else. Some kind of angelfish? Okay, golden spadefish juvenile. In juveniles, the body dorsal fin and anal fin are long and distinctly shaped. Silver in color, with many black lines that can be found year-round. Now, I thought I saw in the corner of my eye when I landed some kind of sea dragon, but it might have been those, whatever we just called them, I already forgot. Spadefish. Oh, guys. I don't know if it's coming through very clearly on the microphone, but I was just doing this before. You can hear the awful Wii speaker, microphone, what is it? Wii controller speaker. If I can just turn around. I'm doing this while the controller is like at my face level. So I want you to hear that. So good. We can hear it, thank goodness. Ooh, look at these little guys. Bicolor parrotfish, juvenile. Oh, they do look different, and they did mention that they were different colors when they're the parrotfish. When they're juveniles. You can tell I'm getting tired, right? It's 10 o'clock. But yeah. You can tell. That's fun. So yeah, the goal of this game just seems to be touch as many fish as you can. Which is, like, typically a good goal in life as well. The prior game was all about salvaging stuff. But, you know, I think that's cool that they're going a different direction with this. I guess it makes more sense for the Wii also, which is, like, very aimed towards kids. Or, like, more casual gaming experiences to not have, like, a nitty-gritty RPG where you need to grind for money. Or, you know, can be killed. Is there anything else out here? Who knows? I keep seeing these spadefish and keep thinking they're, We were watching Pokemon for a bit, so I missed, like, an hour. Is there any narrative? It's pretty much just Fish Toucher. We are chartered by some, what do you call it? Some organization that's funding us. This seems safe. In EverBlue, I would have died 3 times over by now. Okay, they're not. Open sea lies beyond this point. Don't do it. It's not worth it. That's fair. I'm losing my train of thought. Yeah. So, there's like the Mariana Foundation. They want to pay us to look after wildlife. Ooh, cool. Look after the seas, and that's pretty much it. Clownfish, wow. Who's the clown now? That's pretty much it so far. And now we're like a tour guide. That's pretty much all there is to it. Clown anemone fish. One of the most popular fish in the sea, the clown anemone fish have narrow elliptical bodies with incredible color patterns of orange, white, and black. It can be seen year-round in the coral reefs. Thank goodness. So yeah, so far, no. We just get emails on our BlackBerry, and that's it. It's not like EverBlue where it's like, oh, you got shipwrecked, and you know your dad's a great sailor or whatever, or a diver, and you need to live up to his legacy, and you got to repair your boat and help the people of the island. So far, it's been none of that. It's literally just been, go do science, go learn about fish, because you can. And by golly, I've learned so much about the elliptical body shapes of so many different fish species. It's excellent. But that spooked the hell out of me also, but that's the butt-shaped ring that I drew with the pen earlier. How do I get these dolphins to become my best friend? I need more tools. I think they said mammals love sound, but I don't have a way to make sound yet. So I just gotta use the... I liked the story in EverBlue. Yeah, it was truly an RPG. Like, it really lived up to being a RPG that is primarily based around diving. Oh, snap! We're in it. We're in it, gang. We're in it. Here we go. That's what it's all about. Right there. Green sea turtle, baby. They got a couple of these at the aquarium near us, the New England Aquarium, right? And one of them is 70-something years old. She eats, like, 20 pounds of cabbage a day. It's very cool. Bodies of these reptiles are encased in a hard shell from which the head, the tail, and long flipper-shaped legs protrude. Their shells are dark and brown on the top and light yellow underneath. This creature can be seen year-round. Wow. You have a very long-distance pet. Yeah. I look forward to when I can get these guys in the aquarium. Zoom, enhance. Very nice. Very clearly the same sea turtle model as EverBlue 2 also, which is funny. But what can you do? Very nice. Well, that makes this whole trip worth it. I could care less about the dolphins, but... Oh, now I can look around also. They didn't let me do this in my first dive. Oh. That's the ocean for you. Let's get the hell out of here. So I don't know. I don't know if there's going to be suddenly like a shocking twist story. We're only, I guess, in relative terms, partially into this, like very, very in the early game still. I've only been streaming for a little over 2 hours, and I'm sure this game is much longer than that. I'm also dawdling. I'm sure the speedrun for this game could be done quite quickly. Okay, we got more lore. Oh, it's nighttime now. Can't dive at night yet. Still don't have a flashlight. Don't know how to get one. We get good music at night. Oh! This is safe. I don't think you're supposed to touch one of these. Seems ill-advised. Walrus. Odobinus rosmarus. These huge brown mammals are covered in a thick hide that conceals the heavy layer of fat. The mouth, which is surrounded by short, stiff whiskers, sports two tusks that are thicker and longer than males. The creatures may appear on the boat from time to time. Well, I mean, he's a seal, so he's allowed to do what he wants, but, like, let's just consider how big his tusks are and how much this thing weighs compared to my frail little human body. He can do what he wants. Like, I'm not gonna tell him one way or the other. Catherine, what's up? I need guidance. Okay, so now I gotta go find my dolphin partner. His tusks are, in fact, as big as me. That's the tusks. get the hell out of here. Back to the lagoon. I hope there's no... I missed the music from EverBlue 2. Like, this is all very chill and it fits the vibe of where we're at right now. But I missed the crazy, like... Mariachi.wav of EverBlue. That was really good stuff. It was so good. Can I pet this guy again? Now that it's like a separate day? Learn more? Yes, I can. Walrus fact number 2. Their distinctive tusks are usually around 15 inches long on females, but it can be up to 3 feet long on males. Both sexes use the tusks to pull themselves out of the water, and males also use them for mating-related plays. They prefer to live in large herds that can number up to several thousand strong. Think how much weight there is in a herd of walruses if each one weighs several thousand pounds, right? And there are several thousand walruses. That's just so much weight. That's incredible. Let's dive. Let's go find our dolphin. Alright, there he is. Oh, that dolphin. He's stuck. Oh, he's just stuck. He can't get out because he can't see. Cool. You're so right. Alright, let's get this dolphin out of here. First, I gotta pet a manta ray. The dolphin's not going here. He's fine. He's just having a fun little look around. Manta ray is the important part. Alright, what's new about manta rays? It is thought that the name manta, which means blanket in Spanish, was given these creatures because of their shape. Their unusual fins on left and right of their mouths evolved from pectoral fins. There's a large amount of variation in the speckled markings on their underside. In fact, some specimens are completely black. Dolphin. It's following me. Let's lead into the coral forest, which is to the east. Or I guess, namely, it's the way that they are pointing me. I think. We got to save a dolphin, at least that spawn. Yeah. Oh. Is the spot gonna get muted again? Yeah, this Celtic music is interesting, though. Follow this dolphin. These mammals have spindle-shaped bodies with short, wide beaks. They're gray on their back and a light gray on the belly. Can be seen in the central hall of the Moya Atoll. Ruins. Interesting. There are ruins, okay. That's a little bit of world building that I wasn't privy to. There are going to be ruins down here. That's exciting. Do I get my third hophead ass back soon? Yes. We've maxed out the information about the hophead ass. These are the largest of all wrasses, reaching lengths of up to 7 feet and weights of over 400 pounds. One of the more popular fish for large-scale aquariums. However, a recent drop in their wild numbers has qualified this fish for international protection. That's good to know. The apex of beautiful, relaxing Wii games, yeah. A little bit different than the RPGs of the previous games in the franchise, but these fish have beak-like mouths and unusual teeth that they use to pluck at algae-covered coral and grind it up for food. The ground-up coral can then be excreted from the body. The majority of white sand found around coral is thought to be excreted by this fish. What a good role the parrotfish serves in the ecosystem here. All the sand in the ocean came from parrotfish, is what I'm being told here. But the songs don't loop. Why? Why? Why not? Why can't they just make the music loop? Oh, it did. Okay. We're good. They fixed it. We're good. I can't wait to find out that this entire section of the VOD gets muted, though. That's gonna be crazy. Just gotta take a breath. You're right, you're so right, you're so right, I'm sorry. I'm asking for way too much. It does look like an ocean documentary. They definitely tried something new. They didn't just make EverBlue 3, which I respect them for. I mean, I guess that's why it's a different name. It's not just called EverBlue, even if it is very clearly a spiritual successor. The Gabbiano? You like that? You think that's fun? Pretty amazing, by the way. I've never seen a wild dolphin act so friendly. Bird! Bird! Bird. There's a bird. I need to go talk to the bird. No! Come up! Maybe it'll come back. Never mind. Anyway, people of Pelago loved dolphins. Long ago, they thought they were the holy messengers of a sort. They trust you now, so they make sure you're nice. I couldn't work with somebody who didn't respect animal life. Oh yeah, here, take this. Oh, nice. So they were saying how mammals love sound before, and now I can make sound. The hip, young marine biologist crowd, like Jotaro Kujo, and, that's it. Try using it to signal dolphins. I will do that. Use the stern to access a training point where you can interact with your partner. Do I have a partner yet, though? Like, I just met this dolphin. New penguins! Multiple types of penguins. We're gaming so hard right now, gang. Cormorant. Come back, Cormorant. Alright, penguin, I need your next pack. Thank you. I've maxed out my social link with African penguin. They shed their plumage during a time called molting period. Once this happens, it is very easy for their body temperature to drop, making it possible for them to hunt. It takes around 18 days to regrow their plumage. An average bird loses 5 ounces of weight on each of those days. To avoid starving, they consume large amounts of food before molting starts. That's crazy. Imagine if you just couldn't eat while your dry cleaning was being done. That's ridiculous. And this is an Adelaide penguin, right? Gen 2, maybe? I forget. We'll find out in a second. Adelaide Penguin, I was right. So they do starve, they just like tough through, yeah. Adelaide Penguin. These birds have spindle-shaped bodies, but the short decorative head feathers give them a slightly angular look. They're black on the backsides and white on the belly, and they appear on your boat from time to time. Cormorant. No, wait, you're not a cormorant. You're some kind of, I don't know, booby, I think. Brown booby, yeah. Sula Leucogaster, very good name. Sorry that this stream now has, I'm above that joke, actually. These birds have short wings and long tapered tails. Their beaks are quite sharp and contain many jagged edges. Their heads and their backs are black, and bellies are white. Brown boobies may appear on your boat from time to time. So many birds, I love it. So now can I use the whistle? Or can I only do that while I'm, like, looking at an animal? Okay, this one won't use the whistle here. I don't know why I would, that would be cruel and unusual. Just whistle a bird. I don't know why I went to the bow when they were like at the stern. Did the, like, ocarina call, and I've summoned my horse. Oh, we get to name the dolphin. Sassy, what do you think? You don't like it? Well, then what kind of name did you have in mind? We get to name the dolphin. Oh, boy. Is there like a, I could just go for like Echo if I wanted to be funny. Or not funny, if I wanted to be basic. I should have named my character after the main guy from EverBlue, just to pretend like it's the same guy. I can name this dolphin after Leo from EverBlue. Unless anybody has like a really funny dolphin name that you've been sitting on all stream waiting for your chance to name this thing. In which case I'd be all ears, but otherwise I have no real skin in the game on this one. He can kind of be whatever. Jotaro. You know, I actually do like naming it Jotaro. That's funny. Eyes have it. Is this okay? Absolutely. That's a good name. Yes. Hey, that's really good. How about teaching you a trick? Jotaro selected. Point to your partner's mouth or fin and press A. Release it and then press it again while moving the Wii remote in direction. This will give him a command. Make it stop time, that's a good trick. So it says, like, back and forth, right? Hold on. I don't understand. I'm waggling the remote as hard as I can. Very aggressively. Hold on, I need to read the tooltips again. Hold A while that's what I was doing. That's what I thought, right? It said like press them on the mouth. He's like, hold on. Like, and then. Oh, okay. Waggle controls, everybody. Sick front flip. That ruled, dude. He's trying to say something. That's all you got, pal? Your partner's tricks will evolve and change like a Pokemon. I don't follow this. I'm not sure. Yeah. I don't. Use a hand action. Use a signal or give the go sign. Okay. Spin jump. He's doing it. He's gaming. Chotaro, you're so talented, my dude. Please. Please. I have no idea. Waggle controls, I really don't understand. We get all these cool camera angles. Tail walk, wow. Very good. I'm very proud of you, Jotaro. Good boy. Ooh. Let's see, if I get like a cool story hook, I will probably call it there for the evening. Is there anything cool in my Japanese bullhead shark spawn? During this time of the year, Japanese bullhead sharks gather in the Mauna Loa coastal waters to spawn. They are spawning now, occurring in the G5 area of your map. Okay, let's do that. Let's go do that, and then I'm probably going to call it for the evening. G5. Let's go into shark-infested waters for good old time's sake. And then I'll find somebody to raid and call it the evening. Speaking of, while I'm doing my spiel... I will be streaming again tomorrow, a little bit earlier than this time, I believe. Continuing my ongoing Pokemon Ribbon Master quest. Surely this time I will get the Battle Tower, for real, for real, for real. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. I'm sure it'll happen this time. And I'll also be doing the Kalos Elite 4. And then we can move on to Gen 7, hopefully. That's the plan, right? So if you're interested in Pokemon, want to see me collect every single ribbon in the entire franchise, I'll be doing that like 6:30, probably ET tomorrow, and that'll be my only other stream this week. Here's hoping, at least. I really, really hope it pans out. But we will see. I've been stuck on the battle tower for so long. Every time I get really close, I lose focus towards the very end and I get knocked down. But hopefully this time, because I'm starting midway through, I will not lose focus, because it will not be as long of an endurance run, and then I can just do whatever it is that I need to do. Okay, so I've taken my dolphin friend into what I'm told are shark-infested waters. Ganbare, thank you so much. It's literally been, like, I think 4 times in a row I've been at the battle tower and just haven't made it quite far enough. But this time for sure. I've got a very good strategy involving Dusclops, which is a very cool Pokemon, and a level 1 Aeron. Because that's just the way you have to cheese it in the battle tower. Use, like, the oldest tricks in the book. Okay, shark. Kill me, shark. Prove to me you're gonna be violent. Or just sit there, that's cool too. Good? Hi. Alright, I'm gonna guess the sharks in this game are non-violent. Zebra shark. Well, it's not even the same type of shark I was looking for. These fish have broad bodies and heads and tail fins that are roughly the same length as their bodies. They are an earthy brown color on top and white on the belly with a leopard print. Now, why is it called a zebra shark if they're called a leopard print? Seen near Deep Valley. Yeah? Okay. Yeah, it doesn't, which is maybe good. Yeah, so I'm gonna get the shiny thing, and I guess we're gonna explore Deep Trench next week. Same bat time, same bat channel. Ooh. Storyboard fragment, wow. No, there's more, there's a guy there also. I wasn't done. I have to inspect the littlest guy. We don't even know what he is. Stark's Demacile? These fish have narrow spindle-shaped bodies. They're vibrant blue. Cool, cool, cool. I love learning about the body shapes of all these fish. Yeah, so maybe there is survival elements, because that was about as ominous as music could come, I would think, for this game. I don't have, like, a flashlight or anything, so I don't know if I'm, like, legally allowed to go in the hole. I guess I am. But let's save this for next week, I think. I'm getting kind of tired. It's like 10:30 here. Cool! So there is something. There is stuff. I could swear I just saw a guy. I have to inspect this guy. That's cool. So that's really exciting. There is, I guess, the trench, which is always where the good stuff is in the ocean. Wait, Marlin? No. Buddy, let me look at you. Okay, that was interesting. Marlin, buddy. Oh, he, like, sticks the sail up when you tap him. That's funny. Indo-Pacific sailfish. Now, that's a spindle-shaped body if ever I've seen one. Long bodies, extremely large dorsal fins that are designed to break waves and lengthy snouts. Very cool. Deep Valley. But I didn't see the bullhead sharks that they were talking about. That's a scary looking animal right there. We just saw these worthless zebra sharks that nobody gives a shit about. Who even cares? It's not a Japanese bullhead shark. Cool. Well, so I think that'll probably do it for me. I see the sharks moving towards me, and I'm like, I should be afraid. But then they don't bite me. So maybe the hole is fine. Maybe the hole is safe and just dark. Maybe there's nothing to worry about. But we'll find out next week. I'm too tired to engage on a brand new adventure right now. But that was cool. I liked the musical stinger a lot. That was fun. Let's go back up to the Gabbiano and ponder our next move. Crucially, this is also... Maybe zebra sharks just aren't the kind of sharks that bite people. You might be right. I don't know. That's the other thing. Is it's like, now it's really lulling me into a false sense of security, right? Like, I've encountered a couple sharks, and they haven't been aggro. But that just means that when one of them is aggro, I'm going to be caught really off guard, which maybe makes it worse. I don't know. I really don't know what to expect. I have no clue. Both sharks and zebras have been known to bite. Really bad. What's wrong? Story hook for next time. Don't sneak up on me like that. Oh gosh. I see the walrus like just out of frame. I've got a problem. See, the aquarium on the mainland is open next month. Asked me to help coordinate the main tank display. You know, like which fish to put on there and such. But doing that means I have to get inside the tank. And she can't swim. If only we knew somebody who'd want to set up an aquarium. Well, I don't know anybody like that. That's rough. Sorry, Catherine. Yeah, it's me. That's me. The guy that I am. Oh, wow, it's on the map, okay. Well, first I have to go talk to a man about a walrus. And then we can go see what the aquarium's all about. And then we can call it a day. Okay, cool. Oh, and other seal types also. And this is a lady walrus. Oh, no, this is a sea lion, not a walrus. Wow, okay, that guy opened up real quick. South American sea lion. These creatures have spindle-shaped bodies that are covered in a heavy layer of fat. Wow. Body shapes. Cool. You're like a monk seal? What are you? Spotted seal. Wide body. Short stubby necks. Round heads. Very good. Okay, well, let's go to the aquarium, I suppose. Yeah. Get to the mainland. Yeah. Is this going to be run by Cal the Fish Lover from the last game? I'd love that. Mankind's creativity enhances the splendors of nature in a microcosm all I can enjoy. That's a very optimistic way of thinking about aquariums. Oh, no, okay. All I can enjoy. You can't learn about creatures by interacting with them in the aquarium, that makes sense. Come back to me when you've done that. Who can I pop in here? Oh, like anybody. Perfect. I was just dropping animals inside of it, but it seems like that's what this one is as well. They said you can design it, but I've been given no interface for that. Okay. This is shot for shot how I ended my first ever blue stream, if memory serves, as I was focused in on an aquarium turtle. And I was just like, bye-bye, everybody. So that's how we're going to do it here as well. I'm going to go look at my Rolodex of folks who are streaming right now. I'm sure there's no shortage of them. Once again, big thank you to Big Ham for the raid. If you haven't given her a check out already, I highly recommend you do it. She's a large gaming hamster on twitch.tv, bigham_vt. Artist, talented model maker, gamer, really a real luminary in the field. And thank you all who stopped by through the raid. I really appreciate it. So now I'm going to go probably send you over to my... I know who's going. Give me a quick moment. A lot of people are streaming tonight. Oh, okay. This is an easy one. I'm going to send you guys over to Fang. Fangu. She's going through itch.io horror games right now. So your mileage may vary. I don't know if they're actually scary or not. But she's a darling. She's super nice. Go hit her with one of my signature pizza emotes if you want. And she's a real treat. World's cutest caveman kind of thing. I'll be back tomorrow at around 6:30 until I'm not. Going to be playing Pokemon X on my actual 3DS. Going to try and capture every ribbon on my Torkoal. I am at 22 out of 36. Actually, I can give you a quick peek on that. It looks like this. This is my current ribbon progress for Pokemon. We are stuck on the Skillful Battler ribbon, which is the last of two that I need in Gen 6, and then I can move on to Gen 7. So I really, really want to move on to Gen 7, because I would like to be able to move on to Gen 8 and 9 so I can do the ranked level ribbon before too long. But also, I'm just kind of getting tired of it. It's fun and all, but I can only do the battle tower so many times and get knocked down before my 50th consecutive battle so many times before I go insane. It is what it is, though. I love Pokemon a whole lot. I'm very excited. I'm actually staffing at a tournament this weekend on Saturday, which will be fun, like a Premier League tournament IRL as part of my Pokemon professorship. It's exciting, exciting. I'll talk more about that tomorrow during my Pokemon mindset. But yeah, thanks all for stopping by. This should be a fruitful month of me maybe getting scared in the abyss or maybe just touching a lot of fish. Either way, win-win. Go be nice to Fang, and I'll catch you all next time. Bonus era, and good night.